Hi, this is Josh with Ringover. Ringover allows you to create and customize your very own IVRs, otherwise known as switchboards, in just a few clicks. Let's take a look at how to do it, shall we? First, you'll need to access your Ringover dashboard by visiting dashboard.ringover.com. Then, move your cursor over the configuration icon and click IVR. From here, you can view, manage, and modify any of the parameters relating to your IVRs, and of course, you can also create a new IVR from this page. To do so, just click the Create an IVR button towards the top of the screen. This will bring up the IVR Creation menu, and that's where the real fun begins. First up, you have the option to name your IVR anything you choose. You can even assign a custom color to your IVR, which will help identify it in your call logs and will improve your call organization. You also have the option to enable conversation recording. When the toggle is clicked, you'll see further customization on this option, like the percentage of calls that will be recorded, as well as the ability for participants to start and stop the recording. If you'd like, you can assign custom numbers to your IVR, but we'll get to how to assign numbers to your IVR in just a little bit. In the next configuration box, you can view everything relating to your IVR scheduling in terms of open and closing hours. Here, you can set your own custom rules and responses depending on your opening or closing scenarios. To modify opening or closing times, simply click and drag the handles at the end of the blue lines on each day. If you'd like to add multiple opening timeframes to a single day, just double-click the gray space on the bar corresponding to the day you'd like to modify. Once you're happy with the opening and closing times for a particular day, you can click the three dots to the right of the bar in order to apply these timeframes to the entire week. Copy or paste timeframes, or remove the timeframes from that day altogether. If you'd like to add a special opening and closing scenario for a holiday or other specific purpose, just click on Special Dates, and you can specify the period of time and specific opening or closing hours for your unique day. Now that we're familiar with how to set our IVR schedule, it's time to define its behavior. To set specific behavior for your opening and closing scenarios, just click one of the dots under Scenario. As an example, let's modify our open scenario. This will be what happens when a caller calls during our defined business hours. By default, the IVR will be set to send calls directly to your Ringover team with no particular preference. However, if we click the blue box towards the top of the Modify Scenario section, we can modify our IVR's basic behaviors. We can, for example, choose to begin with a vocal message or present our callers with a nested IVR. In other words, the classic press 1 for customer service, press 2 for sales, etc. There are many ways to customize your IVR, and you can add multiple steps by clicking the Insert a Step option for nearly endless possibilities. Let's take a look at a very basic opening scenario. First, we would choose Send Calls to Power Users in order to have the call directed towards our Ringover team. Afterwards, you have the option to record or create your own personal vocal greeting, how you would like your incoming call traffic to be delegated to your team, and define which team members will receive the calls on this IVR. Finally, you can define the behavior if no one picks up the call. It could be as simple as a disconnect or as complex as redirecting them to a completely different team or external number with custom menu options. Remember that you can also set custom behavior for your IVR's closing scenario, which in general is a simple vocal message. Once you've got everything just the way you like it, just click the Save This IVR button. But wait, we haven't assigned numbers to your IVR yet. Doing this is super easy. After saving, you'll be back on your IVR configuration page. Simply find the IVR you'd like to add the number to, and then click the plus sign to the right of the IVR ID box. You'll be able to assign any available number on your Ringover account to this IVR in two clicks. If you made it this far, congratulations! You now know the basics of one of Ringover's most important features. Thanks for watching.